Hello students, good morning everyone. I am Miss Purva. Today we are going to learn the next lesson of mathematics. Students, last week you enjoyed the reading and writing the numbers in words. And today we are going to learn how to count numbers in groups. So our next lesson is counting numbers in groups. Can you count these matchsticks? Okay, count it. Yes. So by counting one matchstick, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, we will count all the matchsticks. So these matchsticks are 35. Now we will count these matchsticks by another method. For that, we will make a group of 10 matchsticks. This is the one group of 10 matchsticks. This is another group having 10 matchsticks. This is third group. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 single matchsticks remained. Now, a group of 10 matchsticks means 1 10, and a single matchstick means 1 unit. So here are 3 groups of 10 matchsticks, that is 3 tens and 5 single matchsticks remain. So 5 matchsticks means 5 units. So you can see again, there are 3 bundles of 10 matchsticks. So 10, 20 and 30, that is 3 tens and 5 single matchsticks. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 means 5 units. So total 35 matchsticks are here. So we counted these matchsticks by two method. In first method, we counted like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 till 35. And in another method, we made groups of matchsticks. In each group there are 10 matchsticks. So there are 3 groups, 3 tens and 5 single matchsticks means 5 units. So another method is easier to count, that is making group of 10. Now we will count a given objects by making groups. So see here, Ahmed's friends have some sticks. They have been counted by making groups of 10. Salma had 24 sticks. So here she made a group of 10 matchsticks. So there are 2 groups, each group having 10 matchsticks, means 2 tens, and remaining sticks are 4. These are single matchsticks, so 4 unit. So 2 tens means 20 plus 4 unit means 4. 20 plus 4 is equal to 24. Did you understand, students? Okay. Now we will count these matchsticks. A Sharad had 45 sticks. Can you write these 45 in the form of tens and units? Okay. So here are 4 groups of 10 matchsticks. That is 4 tens and A single mastics are 5. So 5 units. So 4 tens means 40 plus 5 units. 40 plus 5 is equal to 45. Now count these beads. We have to count all beads here. So here are 4 strings of beads. Each string carries 10 beads. So here are 1, 2, 3 and 4 strings. It means that 4 groups of tens, that is 4 tens, and 1, 2 and 3. 3 single beads, that is 3 units. So we will write this way. 4 tens plus 3 units. 4 tens means 40 plus 3 units. So 40 plus 3 is equal to 43. So here are 43 total beads. Now see how the numbers given in the picture have been written. So in first picture, there are 1 tens and 2 units. 1 tens means 10 plus 2 units. That is 10 plus 2, 12. See the next. Here are 2 groups of tens. That is 2 tens and 8 units. That is 28. In the next picture, there are 4 groups. 1, 2, 3 and 4. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 single. That is 7 units. So 10 plus 7 units. That is 40 plus 7, 47. So in this way, you can write the tens and units. So here, one string is there. That one string means a group of 10 beads. Means 1 ten and 4 single beads. That is 4 units. In the next picture, here are 2 notes of 10 rupees, that is 2 tens, and 8 single coins, that is 8 units. In the third picture, here are 4 bundles of matchsticks. Each bundle carries 10 matchsticks. So 4 tens and 7 single matchstick means 7 units. So you can write this 1 ten and 4 units, that is 14. 2 tens and 8 units means 28. 4 tens and 7 units, that is 47. Did you understand, student? Okay. So by using this method, we can count numbers easily. Thank you, students.